All right, what's your diagnosis? Yep, onychomycosis. Important to culture because there are mimickers of onychomycosis, and we'll talk about those. And the reason to treat this is if it's painful or if it's just sometimes cosmetically not acceptable, or it might be getting in the way of clothing, shoes, socks. It's the diagnosis, you get separation of the nail plate from the nail bed, you get crumbling and thickening of the nail. Here's the pearl, not all nails are affected equally in onychomycosis. Look for corroborating evidence. Look for that moccasin, erythema, and scale, and you should confirm the diagnosis by culture. Trichophyton rubrum is the most common cause. T. tonsurans, Trichophyton tonsurans for tinea capitis, Trichophyton rubrum, the most common cause for onychomycosis. So what I'll do here is if this patient is really bothered by it and they want treatment or they need treatment because it's painful, I'll trim back this stuff that's on the edge, and then I'll take like a 15 blade or a real tiny curette, and I'll go underneath that nail plate, and I just have a little a sterile cup, and I'll put some of the nail stuff in that cup, the crumbling nail, and I send it off to the lab to identify if it's a trichophyton rubrum. Here are the treatment regimens: fluconazole, itraconazole, terbinafine. You like to treat with a positive culture. I'm going to throw a little wrinkle in there. 50% of the time, you don't get a positive culture. So now you're stuck, but at least you tried. And you can, you know, with appropriate monitoring, put them on these treatments, but there's no free lunch. We put someone on terbinafine and developed neutropenia, had to be hospitalized. That's rare, but there's no free lunch with any systemic medication. You can always have a side effect. Warn about recurrence. I know in earlier lectures you talked about that. Topical antifungals after systemic treatment. So if I get someone clear with systemic therapy, I will then make sure they use an over-the-counter Lotrimin or over-the-counter terbinafine on their feet. Try to do that, you know, daily to as frequently as they can to prevent recurrence. So everyone know how it starts? Think about it. It's moccasin, erythema, and scale. So it starts in the skin, and then it invades the distal nail plate and starts moving back. So if you keep the skin clear, you're going to prevent that fungal organism from invading the distal edges of the nail plate and working its way back. And it takes 6 to 12 months for those new nails to grow out. Manage expectations. Look at the cure rate, not high, and it takes 6 to 9 months to see results. Because the medicine is cool. It gets deposited in the nail matrix, and it's present there for 90 to 120 days, and it just works its way out, sort of mowing like a lawnmower, chewing up all that fungus, okay? So the question there is, are you not doing any pulse therapy? You can do pulse therapy. There are so many regimens out there. I'm fine with that. I think pulse therapy is fine. And I know in an earlier talk, there was an example of how to do pulse therapy. I was looking at the syllabus. But psoriasis is in the differential diagnosis of onychomycosis. Psoriasis, you typically get all nails affected. Remember, with onychomycosis, it doesn't affect all nails equally. And you can get dystrophic nails with psoriasis. You can get pitting, as shown here, these tiny pits. But they're going to have other evidence of psoriasis. They might have joint pain. They might have their red scaly plaques. Look, I put this in here because all nails are affected in this patient with psoriasis. Onycholysis is the finding where you get separation of the nail plate from the nail bed, and you get increased subungual debris. But that looks like onychomycosis. But there's corroborating evidence for the diagnosis of psoriasis. Why do we treat this? Interference with shoe sizing and hosiery, discomfort, difficult nail care, and there are patients that are just psychologically impacted, and we owe it to them to try to get it better. I treat fewer and fewer patients as I've progressed in my practice. Their recurrence rate is so high. So the question there is, what about the diabetic patient? If the diabetic patient has recurrent cellulitis and we think that the onychomycosis and the tinea infection of the feet is a portal of entry for the bacterial organisms, yes, you should treat. Definitely treat.